Hi, my name is Justin Stelzer, and this is the second Hundley one-on-one meeting dated for 420. So, as we know, Hundley is looking to decide between either a high-end rod or a low-end Walmart rod. So for the high-end rod, on the product market mix, we're going to place that in the product development square, but it's also more toward the diversification only because it is a new product type altogether, but it is trying to appeal to the existing market of the avid or competitive space. And what's interesting is that the avid competitive target customer represents 80% of sales of all fly fishing rods. So this is a thick market that is fairly saturated, probably. We're going to need some more information from competitors for that. But if Hundley can continue its value add there, it might be able to appeal to a value add logical step up for an avid target customer. Then we have the product market matrix for Walmart, and we think it's more of a market penetration point where it is an existing product in terms of build, and it's going to be an existing market. However, it's also kind of in the market development sector where it's looking to bring people into the sport. However, the beginner target fisherman only represents 4% of the total market, and Hundley's going to have to place a lot of orders. It's going to have to appeal to a lot of people and new people in order to sustain that. That said, so the base case for both of these, basically what I did for the sensitivities was I didn't have any cannibalization for the Klamath and Walmart rod at the bottom here, but instead I based the highs off of what was sort of like the minimum order. So the high for the Klamath and Tiddalook rods is just a 10% cannibalization best case, average price of $600 based on, let's say they did 50% wholesale at 400 and 50% retail at 800, and that's just off the 7,000 units that they ordered. And on the low end, we had 15% cannibalization. That'll probably change before my final recommendation, but that's what I have for right now. And the wholesale price only at 7,000 units, and you get the spread between almost 8 million for the first EBITDA, and then around 6.5 for the second EBITDA there. And actually at the high end, that ends up meeting that sales target of 10%, where in the low end, it definitely does not. At the Klamath Walmart rods, both are going to hit that sales goal of over 10% for this year. And that was based on a high of 100,000 units that was anticipated in the Walmart sales at a price of 65 per unit. And the lowest cost of goods sold that was represented in that range there of 24 to 32.5. And at the low end, we're looking at the highest cost of goods sold with only 72,000 base units at $65 a unit. And you're still getting in between, you got a lower range there about the same range, I guess, between the two in terms of top end and low end. But you're gonna be making more money at the low end on the Walmart rods there, but we don't know if that's the right move or not yet without qualitative data. So what this tells us is that Walmart has a lower deviation range for its EBITDA and guaranteed purchase orders. It's a smaller market size, so we're going to have to see if 100,000 units annually is feasible or sustainable year over year. I don't know that there's even that many people that jump into the sport, and if they do, are they going to be jumping in to buy a Walmart rod, or is it going to be more involved than that? The Tiddalook line has a lower worst case of return, but it might be a sustainable advantage in the long run. We still need to figure out the cannibalization of the Klamath line as customers are jumping or buying up from that Klamath line. And what's a reasonable growth expectation over the next 3 years? We're still working that. So my next steps here is I need to fully flesh out both scenarios, but I'm currently leaning towards the Tiddalook rod. It's a bigger market, it's truer to the original brand. The advertising model should be redone and is going to allow for that rebrand that we need to get back to what Hundley was supposed to be. And the Walmart rod just might tarnish the brand name despite the bottom line being higher. We also need to determine the growth rates for both based on the markets. This might include outside research for the total market, how much it grows on a year-over-year basis, what are the cannibalization rates, what do we think that might be, and we might have to sensitivity that metric per se. And then finally, I'm going to have to determine the net present value at the various discount rates. Higher rates are going to, or higher risk, depending on what it's going to be, is going to need a higher return. And then the NPV, if it ends up being the same, we need to look at the qualitative brand image work and see if that's going to be a deciding factor. So thank you.